lupins are one of the most spectacular of all the garden flowers. Tall spires of pastel colors seem to contain all the colors that the rainbow forgot. Its handsome green foliage presents itself well, and its blossoms stay upright, unlike many tall perennials. They also draw swallowtail butterflies. Unfortunately, lupins cannot be divided or transplanted because they develop a taproot which goes quite deep, and they must be started from seed. Lupins require fertile garden soil containing a large amount of peat moss and slightly acidic. I usually start the seed in the springtime by placing two seeds in a 4-inch pot with a mix of 1/3 peat moss, 1/3 garden compost, and 1/3 number one stream wash gravel. It takes about 2 months to grow them into a sizable plant ready for transplant, at which time I can either put them in the garden or I can transplant them to a 6-inch pot to grow onward. Any pots where two lupins come up, I snip one off, usually the weakest one, with my fingernail. As you can see, we've been successful in germinating 10 pots out of 18. An easy way to transplant is to place a pot inside a pot as you fill it with soil. By removing the inside pot, you already have a recess in which to place the transplant. Lupins usually do not bloom until spring of the second year of their growth. But since they winter over so reliably, it is definitely a worthwhile effort. I have had lupins that bloomed consistently for over 10 years, although some of the plants, after one profuse blooming year, die. If the colors aren't as bright as they should be, I have found an application of 20-20-20 fertilizer or muriacid to be quite beneficial. As the season progresses, it is wise to remove the older and spent blossoms. This will promote new blossoms. Also, the older blossoms can be stripped of seed pods and lower flowers, and the tips used as cut flowers in the house.